Kanth Sharma from Osmania Medical College, and I am presenting the case of Kanth Sharma. Baby of PT was brought to the neonatology department with a chest wall defect in the neonatal region. The defect was observed soon after birth by a lower segment cesarean section, and the patient was referred to Nilofar Hospital for women and children. The delivery took place at Golconda Government Hospital. Antenatal history, the pregnancy was good case. There was no history of oligor, polyhydramnios, blood transfusion, infection, thyroid disorder, or exposure to drugs. Folic acid supplementations and iron supplementation were taken. No malformations were detected in the ultrasonogram in the antenatal checkups. Birth history, the baby was appropriate for gestational age, born out of non-consanguineous marriage through LSCS. The indication was that the pregnancy was post-dated. On 2nd June, of 2009, family history was not significant, and the baby was the first born. The vital signs were all within normal examination. The skin was deficient in midline, measuring about 3 to 2 cm, and membranous skin covers the defect. The paradoxical movement of that part was observed with respiration, which can see as seen in this video. The differential diagnosis was pretty obvious to absent sternum, but it could also be as part of the syndrome, the pathology of clinical or Leber syndrome. The patient was first stabilized and provided with interim support therapy in form of IV electrolytes, warm care, and supplemental O2. The tests were carried out simultaneously. The ultrasonogram of abdomen and 2D echo for the structure of heart and abdomen is returned normal, so there were no associated defects, midline defects. Pathology of cabin could be ruled out. And the general examination ruled out Leber syndrome because we expect facial hemangiomas or abdominal trachea or any other conditions. The patient was then referred to NIPS for chest wall reconstruction surgery, where a CT scan revealed no ossification of manubrium or medial length of clavicle. There was suggestion of pectus excavator, but the pericardium was intact and the other structures were normal. The baby was entrusted for surgery on 12th of July. The initial plan was to use a bovine matrix to cover the defect if needed, and the other alternative being primary closure by using sutures. The skin incision was given around the scab, and the pectoralis major flaps were also created. The scab was excised, and then the cartilaginous elements of sternum was observed, so they decided to go with primary closure by taking sutures from the edges and approximating the edges of the sternal bars. The pectoralis majors were approximated in the midline and in the double-breasted fashion. The skin incision was then closed. The post-operative recovery period was non-eventful. The baby was given an antibiotic cover and paracetamol repositories. The drains were removed by 4th day of post-operative, and the patient was discharged on 11th day. They were advised to follow up after 1 week and 1 month. This the measures of 6th day and of 14th day are post op. The sternum is normally formed with fusion of US family bar by 9th week. The cleft can be absorbed in complete, inferior or superior. They may be associated with other features as I mentioned. The incidence was reported as 1 in 100,000 worldwide by some authors. Early intervention is ideal with the cartilaginous complaints of the cartilaginous threats. Alternatives include the bovine acellular matrix and also autologous autogenous bone grafts. Thank
you.
The department cardiology was on the 2nd of August. The wound was healing. The wound healing was good, and there was no associated complications. The healing of the defect itself can be defined only after 1 month or at least 1 month, and there will be subsequent follow-ups will also be required.
Can you tell me something about cancer syndrome? What it is, cancer and
pentology of cancer, typically involves other midline defects, specifically as abdominal, orthopedic defect through which there can herniation can occur, anterior diaphragm. The defect in apical pericardium, there can be various internal cardiac defects, the absence of sternal cleft as mentioned here, and an omphalocy can also be observed. This can be associated in complete or in an incomplete form. We look for the ossification of sternum. It's highly variable, but in some cases the sternum completely forms. In not in the perfect shape, but there is a bone fracture. And we also have to look for any compromises in the mechanics of respiration, changes in any other circulatory mechanics also.